If you think Karl Rowe doesn't sound like a Charlestonian,
I'm bollocks again.
That's because he's not. But if you think Rowe hasn't contributed to the atmosphere and charm of this great city, take a ride in a Charleston black cab.
This building is rumored to be the last building built and paid for by the British before the American Revolutionary War.
The Destination Guide's winner for best taxi service, Charleston Black Cab.
Was born out of my fantasy of the ultimate cab company.
The idea was to bring London's iconic black cabs to the United States. Rowe thought Charleston, a beautiful city with a rich colonial history, made perfect sense. So he packed up the family and moved from London.
And I was proven correct.
Several years ago when we started, our plan, our goal was to raise the bar. And I think that we've not only met that goal, we've exceeded that.
What we aim to do is to make the service seamless between five-star hotel, great restaurant, and the transportation.
We're going to start off at an area commonly referred to as Battery Park, but officially the name is White Point Gardens, and has been such since after the Revolutionary War.
All 11 of the company's taxis are as British as Rowe.
They're quite expensive at $52,000 a piece, but for practical reasons, they are the best vehicle that I could possibly imagine.
Each cab holds 5 passengers in the back and luggage up front. Charleston Black Cab also operates 11 Mercedes Sprinter vans and a 31-passenger Crystal Coach.
This is a fairly rare vehicle for this area. Brought this back from LA several years ago.
The novelty of our vehicles obviously draws people in, but once you get past the novelty of the vehicles, the practicality of the actual vehicle is immense.
Well, they make the driving experience with feeling, you might say.
And when our passengers are happy, when our passengers are wowed, that is the most important thing, and that's the thing that feels the best about being the owner of this company.